Hey there, you guys. Shaun Allen here for Shaun Films Disneyland Video Series. Welcome to my next Disneyland vlog. Hate to tell you this, but this vlog, as you probably saw in the title of this video, is called a late vlog because technically this was supposed to be uploaded back in January and it's already March of 2015, so whoops. Anyways, hope you guys enjoy the vlog. It's pretty long because I wanted to get this one over with and done with because I have plenty of other pieces of footage I want to work on and upload. And I can't do that unless I upload this one. So here you go. Enjoy the vlog. See you later. Bye. Good morning. Hi. It's time for a vlog. Man, I woke up early. The reason why is because I want to be at the parks today early because there's a new area in Disney California Adventure that's opening today, and that's the new Frozen section of Disney California Adventure in, I think it's Hollywood Land. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to that. I'm hoping today that it's not going to be super crowded because this is referring to Walt Disney World. There's a family that I'm watching on YouTube called, their channel is called View from the Cheap Seats. They were saying that the parks over there were not going to be super crowded right now because of the holidays. You know, they're over basically. I'm pretty much betting that's going to be the exact same thing with Disneyland and Disney California Adventure. Not only that, but there are a ton of attractions right now that are closed due to refurbishment. So hopefully people are reading the websites and be like, oh, these attractions are not going to be open. I want to be able to ride those attractions, so maybe today is not a good day. I'm looking forward to the new Frozen area. I'm going to try some new, hopefully I'm going to try to get in 2 Mealtime and Disneyland episodes today. It's very unlikely that will happen, but we'll see. Also going to be doing some new attractions. And I'm also doing a sequel to one of my videos. It is the No Smiling on the Teacups Challenge. If you guys have seen that video, there's actually a moment where I turn the camera and where you're not seeing me, like, throughout the whole video. Big mistake. I was not smiling throughout the entire attraction. It's just that I realized my mistake at that time by turning the camera at that point, and I turned it back to me, and I still wasn't smiling. I was not smiling, so I'm going to do a sequel so that way you guys can fully get the idea that I was not smiling throughout the entire attraction. I will be meeting Princess Anna, Queen Elsa, and Olaf, if they're there today. Hopefully the lines aren't going to be super long for them. And yeah, so without further ado, let's head to Disneyland. Oh, wait, hold on. I need to shave and get ready to go because I'm not really, you know, properly dressed. Be right back. There we go. Now, it's off to Disneyland. Okay, cut to a few minutes later, and now I'm at, not Disneyland, but Ralph's here. And I came by here because I need to get some batteries, because my other camera needed new batteries. So, yeah, now without further ado, let's head to Disneyland. What's wrong with this key? Oh, how stupid of me. It's my Mighty Morphin White Ranger key. Oops. That's not my car key. Here are my car keys. Yeah. I don't want to have an incident like what happened last time, if you guys saw the last episode. Alright, let's see if this one will work. There we go. That's more like it. Oh! Sorry. I'm listening to Radio Disney on the way over there, and I don't want to have copyright infringement on this video. By the way, on our way to Disneyland, I'm going to be doing a time-lapse photography of myself driving to Disneyland from when I get on the freeway to probably when I stop the vehicle in the Disneyland parking lot or parking structure, depending on where they send me. So, yep, here we go. This ought to be a lot of fun. Yeah, especially the editing part. Yikes. So, you're probably going to see this in a matter of minutes, but this will take me, I don't know, maybe an hour. So, you know, me traveling over there. So, let's go! might be going to the Chip and Dale parking lot. This would be like the second time that we've gone here. That's pretty cool. We're going the exact opposite. Yeah, we're going to the parking lot. That's pretty cool.
Disneyland theme park parking.
But yeah, this is pretty cool. Sweet. I got here at the right time and the right day. anyway, so hopefully you guys enjoyed that. It took me, Sean, when you're editing this, how long did it take for me to edit that entire sequence? Post the status right there now. And how long did it take for me really to get here to Disneyland? Probably about an hour. Whoa, there's a lot of vehicles parked. Let me see here. Oh, someone's vlogging. Someone's vlogging over there. All right. Well, there's a lot of people over there. All right, so yeah. Ooh, I got an in spot.
So yeah, look at that. The parking structure is not even open right now. There's hardly any cars in there.
I must have gotten here just as they opened up this area because I'm over in an area where typically I can't park because it's always packed. That means my predictions were correct. It might be a low turnout today. So we'll see if that prediction is correct. But anyways, we're heading out to the Mickey and Friends, and I guess I should say now, the Pinocchio and Chip and Dale trams. So, here we go.
It's interesting because this monopod that I'm using, this Explorer monopod, to me it's almost like my wand, you know what I mean? It's also like, it's like an extension of my arm because now I can extend you guys out further. Like this, see? You guys are way out there. Well, here comes the tram. Ah, here comes the tram. It's like, okay, I had a good nap. Now it's time to go to work.
It's gonna be kind of sad though because I don't think this last Christmas season they didn't put the wreaths on the front of the trams like they usually do. Like, there's usually a wreath by the front there on the, like, I guess that's the door. Yeah, so I don't know why they didn't do that this year. So it's kind of weird. So now we're, okay, that tram's leaving, so we're going to catch this one.
And we're probably going to go on the very end of the tram because
that's where I like to sit.
There goes that one. Oh, maybe we're not going on this one today. Maybe that one's going to the park. The batteries died on this camera, so I'm not going to be able to use this one because this takes AAA, and I didn't get AAA. Dang it! Anyways, yeah, here comes this tram, number 11. How about that?
Ladies and gentlemen, as the tram is approaching, be sure you all safely stand back behind the yellow line on the ground. Do not attempt to board the tram until we come to a complete and final stop. If you have small children in your group, have the children sit in the middle, away from the doors.
I don't have any small children with me today.
Please hold on to hats, glasses, or any loose items that could fall from the tram. If an article should fall, please stay seated until the next stop and inform the nearest cast member.
All right, so I just got off the tram. I'm actually heading in the opposite direction. What is that rumbling coming from? That is so weird because I've never heard any rumblings before. It sounds really odd. Anyways, I hear like this low rumbling, like explosions coming from some sort of attraction, but I don't know what attraction that's from. So I saw a poster over here on the side of this building here I want to get a picture of, and it's pretty cool.
So as of today, January 7th, yesterday, January 6th, the first episode of Agent Carter was on television, and yes, I did see it. It was pretty awesome.
That's the train back there. I also got to see the premiere of the human-sized trailer of Ant-Man. I have mixed feelings about it, but you know what? I think it'd be all right. I think a lot of people are really, like, stressed out over the fact that, you know, it's not a very popular character, you know, Ant-Man, you know? Although, for some of you who are really into the old, like, Avengers comics, he actually started off on, the Avengers. Well, he didn't really start off in the Avengers, but, he became more popular, the Avengers. So, technically, he's been around for quite a long time. But, and he used to have his own character, his own comic book series. But yeah, so Agent Carter was a really cool episode yesterday, and I might continue watching the series. It's only a 7-part series. I would think there'd be more episodes. Okay, what is that rumbling? Where is that coming from? That is like getting on my nerves, but I'm hearing all these rumblings, and I don't know what that's from. Anyways, yeah, let's head into the park. Okay, I hear a song that's playing right now, but I believe it's from this album, the Guardians of the Galaxy album. I actually saw on Facebook and also on Twitter that they actually brought out a tape version of Guardians of the Galaxy album. That's pretty cool. They don't make tapes anymore. You know, we've gone to CDs and Blu-ray and DVDs. But that was actually pretty awesome when they brought out a tape version of the Guardians of the Galaxy music album, or soundtrack, I should say. So, yeah, pretty cool. At first I thought this was the corpse bride, but it's actually the bride from the Haunted Mansion. This would be cool to add to my collection, but I'm running out of room. Oh, well. Oh, there's Alice on a mushroom. Alice in Wonderland. Oh, there's neat pictures. He just tries to be so serious, and it's like you can't help but laugh a little bit about Goofy. Oh, this is pretty cool. Look at this. It's Mickey Mouse wearing one of the suits from 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, and of course that is the Nautilus. That is a neat painting. That is really cool. Here's another cool one. That is really cool. To all who come to this happy place, excuse me, to all who come to this place of dreams, welcome. Disney California Adventure celebrates the spirit of optimism and the promise of endless opportunities ignited by the imaginations of daring dreamers such as Walt Disney and those like him who forever changed and were forever changed by the Golden State. This unique place embraces the richness and diversity of California, its land, its people, its stories, and above all, the dreamers it continues to inspire. Well, I'm definitely a dreamer, so it's definitely inspiring me. By the way, over here, down in the ground, there's a time capsule right here. It was placed into the ground on June 15, 2012, and it's going to be opened up in 2037. That's be pretty cool. I have no idea what's in it, but I bet it's pretty cool. Alright, so I got myself a collection of Frozen Fun maps, you know, for safekeeping. And now we're heading off to see this Frozen Fun, and you can watch the entire video. I'm going to be probably inserting clips into this video, but you can watch the video in its entirety by checking out the annotation that just popped up there on the screen. Or if you can't see the annotation, click the link down below in the description of this video. Okay, let's go see Elsa and Anna.
You can tell how much detail they put into this place. Look at this. They have a rain gutter here. Dump no waste. Drains two waterways. Look at that. Is this really iron? It doesn't feel like it, but just details are everywhere here. Oh, I'm early. Hey guys, look. Snow. Oh, that's not snow, that's something else. I don't know what I just touched, but that was not snow.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, in 1923, Walt Disney arrived in California to follow his dreams. Dreams which led to extraordinary achievements and wondrous adventures. At adventures where natural majesties, bustling communities, and groundbreaking discoveries would all find a place in his heart. Today, we invite you to explore your dreams as you experience your very own California adventure. For your safety and for those around you, we ask that you please walk to your next destination. Thank you and welcome to Disney California Adventure.
Here we go. Here's the Disney Junior stage right over here to the right. Live on stage, I should say. Disney Junior. Mickey Mouse Clubhouse. And Sophia the First. And Jake and the Neverland Pirates.
Yay, I don't watch those shows because I'm too old for those. Seeing a lot of Anna and Elsa's around here. It's really funny.
Here comes the red car. That is so cool. Sorry, my camera's blocking out, but you know, that's the brakes. Looks like a silhouette. So if you look there on the mural, it says there El Capitan. I've been there a couple of times. I've seen Toy Story 2 and Chronicles of Narnia, the Language of the Wardrobe over there. And those were fun. If you've never been to El Capitan in Hollywood, it's a lot of fun. Go and check it out. There goes the other red car. Alright, wow, I might get to see them really early today. So I got my Frozen Fun character close-up at the Disney Animation Building, which is this place right here, which is where Anna and Elsa are. But right now, we're heading into Frozen Fun. We're going to give them a chance to have a, you know, get whatever needs to be set up there first and then go see them. But right now, we're going to Frozen Fun. Here we go. If you want to see the entire video, go and click on the annotation that just popped up on the screen. And, alright, so I gotta start filming. Man, this is fancy. Wow.
I'm sorry, loves.
That's cool. It's like a 3D image right there.
This is unbelievable. This used to be the area where they had the Muppet Vision 3D.
This is unbelievable. This is really nice. Wow.
Alright, so I just met up with Anna and Elsa. If you guys want to watch that video, again, click the annotation that just popped up there on the screen. I'm advertising this Frozen video a lot today. So, so right now I'm in the search for Olaf. And he's got to be around here somewhere. He's got to be around here somewhere. Oh, I see Sophia. Sophia the First over there. I've already met with her before.
Oh, hey, here's Olaf. There he is.
Whoa, there goes Monorail Blue. Perfect. Woo! There's snow! And it's snowing in here.
Secret, it's actually foam. It's actually foam, it's not real snow.
What's coming down from off the ceiling?
That's one small step for man.
One giant leap for snowmankind.
To my guess, and to my knowledge, it is real snow. Look at that, it's just like frozen water. It's basically like ice. In fact, that's exactly what it is. Ugh.
Okay, I know what you guys are gonna ask me to do. No, I can't start a snowball fight, but, one second. I will smack myself with a snowball. Ready? This better not hurt. 3, 2, 1. That didn't hurt, but now my hair's all wet.
Aha! There he is. I found him.
Oops.
There is a really deep section of snow right here. It's literally like, look at that. This goes really deep.
You know, I forgot to tell Anna that I would be glad to make a snowman because I've never made a snowman in my entire life. So, yeah, true fact. Whoa, jeez. It's pretty crazy in here. Great, now my shoes are all wet. So apparently you can't meet Olaf unless you have a pager. Well, okay. I guess I need to get a, I gotta get a pager, I guess. Unfortunately, the wait line for Olaf is technically, even though they say it's an hour long, I had to wait 45 minutes for a pager in order to see Olaf. So technically, it's going to be a 2-hour wait for Olaf. So unfortunately, no Olaf. But I will show you this Olaf here. Here's Olaf. There's Olaf. There's another Olaf. And we were just in there, Olaf's Snowfest. The deal with the pagers is that you can only go around Hollywood Land. And unfortunately, I can't really stick around Hollywood Land because I got other places to go, other places to do, other things to try out. But, yeah. So, well, these are cool. These trees. There's a bunch of Elsa and Anna dolls. I saw something interesting with these. Watch this. So, here you have Queen Elsa. Now, watch this. Underneath, there is Anna. So yeah, that is a little strange for that type of doll, but you know what? Anna and Elsa are sisters, right? But
what's that, blood? Is that a bloody nose?
Hey, Doc!
There's a lot of confetti here. I'm wondering if maybe this was after the Anna and Elsa thing opened up. I recognize the yellow petals from a different show, from the Fantasy Fair Tangled show. But I don't know where this orange one's coming from. I would think that if it was for Frozen, it would be more blue, white, and gray, but who knows, right? Now, you may think I'm at the ocean, because you see this area here. You got seagulls and some ducks over here. But, nope, I'm not at the beach. I'm nowhere near the beach. Well, sort of. All right, here we go to the Pacific Wharf.
Going to be recording a new episode of Mealtime at Disneyland over here at Cocina Cucamonga Mexican Grill. Hope I pronounced that right.
Pacific Wharf. Record catch, 7 1/4 tons. Wow, that's quite a bit of fish. Well, it's an optical illusion. Look, it's hollow.
Eureka! That's pretty cool. So I just enjoyed a semi-good lunch over at the Cocina Cucamonga Mexican Grill. Sometimes I mess up the name. But yeah, it was not too bad. You want to see that episode, click the annotation just popped up there on the screen or click the link down below.
Whoa, I've never been back here before. Look at this. You're going up and up and up.
I was originally going to call this Bigfoot Rapids, but it's not. It's Grizzly Rapids. So, ooh, it's dripping water over here. Yikes, I gotta get out of here. I got cameras.
Yeah, we got some mine cars here. Is there any gold in here? Oh, there's plenty of moss in here. Canoe storage. That's interesting. It says, watch for rocks. Okay, I'm watching the rocks. These are them right here. There's more rocks up there. I'm watching them. There's a waterfall. Big waterfall. You come out over here. This totally reminds me of Knott's Berry Farms Bigfoot Rapids. That's pretty cool. All right. Ah! I'm getting showered. I think there's a leak up there. I think there's a leak right there. That's not good. Whoa.
All right, so I'm about to leave Disney California Adventure, and there's something that I would like to mention to the Disney Imagineers that they need to bring back. Guys, bring back the Buena Vista Bugle newspapers that they used to have over here in Disney California Adventure, because over by the trolley or the red car station right over there, they used to have a little stand where you could pick up some of these, like, they weren't really brochures, but they were like mini newspapers in a way. I mean, the building is still here that says Buena Vista Bugle, but as far as I know, they've discontinued it. So guys, bring it back. Those were fun.
It made it look more realistic with the newspapers.
So, yeah. Guys, bring it back.
Monorail Blue! That's Monorail Blue. My first Disneyland ride review is about the monorail. In fact, it was on that monorail that I did the episode on. Or episodes, because there's two of them. So, guess where we're going right now? That's right. Yep, we're going to Disneyland. I'll just answer it for you. They still have their Christmas decorations up, but it's supposed to be over right about now. All right, so here we are. There's the Main Street Station right up there.
And I predicted this, and my prediction was correct. It was going to be a lot quieter today. And guess what? I was correct.
So here we go. We're about to go underneath the magic tunnel. Here you leave today and enter the world of yesterday, tomorrow, and fantasy. They are advertising Fantasmic, so I just noticed a Fantasmic Fast Pass. There's Star Tours right there. Haunted Mansion, Indiana Jones Adventure. Oh, this is still going on. I thought they were... No, they're going to change this soon. Yeah, sure, because look, the Christmas tree is gone. All right. This is either Chip or Dale. Who is it? Ah, it's Dale.
Chip is over here.
Chip and I are best friends because we had a little interaction together at the Plaza Inn. You guys, if you've seen that episode, check it out. That's him. Which train is it today?
Well, I can't see it.
Oh, I see Goofy here.
There's Mickey Mouse right over there.
All right. It's the E.P. Ripley today. Got that one right this time.
Okay, there's something really cool in here I want you guys to see. You see this park bench right here? This is from Griffith Park.
Griffith Park and me go a long ways because I'm working, well, yeah, I guess I am working with Traveltown right now for the Traveltown series on YouTube, but
this bench came from Griffith Park, and this is supposedly the same bench that Walt Disney sat on when he dreamed of Disneyland. It says the actual park bench, yeah. And here's one of the horses from the merry-go-round. That's in Griffith Park. And this exact same picture, by the way, was in my hotel room back in August of 2014. Here's some peanuts in the peanut roaster right here. Check it out. A 3D model of what Disneyland looked like back in 1955. That is incredible. Just think of it. If you were to picture Disneyland today, this would be where the Indiana Jones Adventure would be. Up there is where Big Thunder Mountain is. More of that would be up in this section here would be Big Thunder Ranch. Got the Haunted Mansion over here, and Pirates of the Caribbean here, and New Orleans Square, and of course you got this whole area here. That's Tomorrowland. Of course, that would expand further. That's where the Submarine Lagoon would be. Beyond Fantasyland would be Toontown. So yeah, they've expanded quite a bit. This is a very, very cool model. Oh, look, I think that is the CK Holiday up there, the miniature train. Yeah, wow. This would be a cool model to build. Yeah, that's Donald Duck in the background. There's the Disneyland Hotel right there. Yeah, pretty cool. Check it out, one of the Mike Fink keelboats, the Gullywappa. That's pretty cool. Oh, wouldn't you know, they've got Frozen stuff in here too. This is concept art of what they were thinking of doing. This is incredible. Here are the models that they used for the characters. Here's Anna and Elsa right here. That's pretty cool. There's some more pictures here. Concept art, as you can see. That is pretty cool. Let's get this penny today. This ought to be interesting. This one. Crunch. Sweet. Oh, that's cool. The Main Street one is right here, so let's get that one.
Here, take it out. There's nobody here.
Got it.
All right, let's get these three pennies now. First, we're gonna do New Orleans.
Okay.
Here comes Frontierland.
Okay.
That was quick. And here comes Tomorrowland. Weird.
Cracker Country. There it is. Crunch. Awesome. All right, let's get Adventureland.
So I just stopped in at the ice cream parlor, and you can probably guess what I got. Yep.
My traditional mint chocolate chip and a cone, or excuse me, waffle cone. How's it going? Oh, peanut brittle. This is the guy that does the candy canes right here.
All right, so I'm about to take the no smiling on the teacups challenge again. I'm here at the teacup ride. There's a semi-small line, so we get on and do another challenge, the sequel that everyone's been asking me to do, because they want to be better than the last time.
All right, you guys, well, I just left Disneyland, and that concludes another vlog. Wow, how about that, huh? Can't believe it. Spent almost an entire day. For those of you who ask me what time do I leave, I usually leave around like 3:30, depending on, you know, I have to worry about the traffic, because usually when I go home, it's crowded. So I have to leave at a certain time period, so I miss the crowds. So, but yeah, I was actually impressed, because today was actually a really good day today. It wasn't as busy as I had predicted, but I was able to get on stuff today very quickly. So I'm gonna make one quick stop in the World of Disney store, because I want to show you guys something really cool.
Oh, look, it's Lumiere. Let me see if I can do the voice.
Bonjour! Welcome to the World of Disney store.
That was okay. Could have done better.
Ooh, check it out. The keys. I've got that one. The Haunted Mansion one. It's pretty cool.
Check it out. They have, ouch, this here, which is pretty cool. This has a bunch of the attraction, like, soundtracks. Stuff from both Disneyland and Disney California Adventure. If you want to hear some really good soundtracks, like if you want to pretend you're inside the parks by listening to these soundtracks, definitely pick this up. They also sell these on Amazon as individual tracks, or you can purchase the whole set for your computer. Yeah, but if you really want to hear some good Disneyland, Disney California Adventure soundtracks, definitely get this. Whenever you're inside the Disney store, look at all the murals and stuff they have in here. It's pretty cool. There's the Mad Tea Party right over there. Hey, check it out. There's Captain America right there. Oh yeah, and there's Thor, obviously. Ooh, they got an orange set. That's pretty cool. All right, one last look at Frozen. Just can't get enough of it. All right, it's a lot of fun today. All right, you guys, well, that is it for today's vlog. There's the Grand California Hotel right there. Hopefully one of these days I'll get into that hotel. That'd be pretty cool. Then I have access to Disney California Adventure very easily. But who knows? All right, I'm here for the tram. Time to go. Bye.
Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of the Disneyland Vlog Series. If you liked it, please be sure to hit the thumbs up button, favorite the video, share your friends, and of course, subscribe to the Disneyland Video Series. And I'm kind of talking quietly because I'm actually at CSUN and there are classes. In fact, I'm actually editing this video, or not video, I mean this audio, in an elevator. In fact, whoo, look at this. See? I'm in an elevator. Because it's like the quietest spot in the whole campus. So anyways, thanks a lot for watching the video. Don't forget to check out my other content here on YouTube. I have Shaun Allen Films, the educational series, the vlog series, and the Travel Town series. I recently posted Travel Town vlog number 4, which is on the top right corner of the screen.
And on the top left corner, I also have the latest episode of Mealtime at Disneyland. Please be sure to check them out and subscribe to them. Oh, the elevator's moving. Gotta go. So thanks a lot for watching, buddy. See you guys next time in another episode of the Disneyland Vlog Series. Okay, bye. The elevator's moving. It's the Tower of Terror.